What is going on, guys? Anthony Mondo here. We are going to Lake Douglas for the volunteer BFL today. I'm guessing they're going to be pushed up in those trees, starting to spawning if they haven't already moved up there. We're just going to see where they're at, because look on Chick, some have spawned, some are still kind of, some are still pushed off. They're all over the place. With the water levels being a little more consistent up there, and them not dropping it so rapidly like they have been on Chick, I'm guessing that they're gonna be in that spawn mode where they're already on beds, and we'll just go from there. Flip those trees, throw a fluke around them, see if we can get, throw a big glide bait, get some on a glide bait. I've never been to this place, but I heard the water's really clear, so I might just throw that glide bait around some of those trees just to see what we can draw out, mark those spots, and then go back and really pick those apart on tournament day. We will see you in a little bit. We're gonna hit the road. When we get a little closer, we'll check back in. We're almost there. We got 11 minutes. See you in a minute. We're on the water. We made it. The ramp's right there. We're gonna head probably about 20, 30 minutes upriver and see what we can't find. All this grass right here. You can find this kind of like yard grass. It can be stacked up in this stuff. Cause it grows out quite a ways also. Into the water. Sometimes those fish will be pulled up right onto it. I'm gonna flip that tree on the way out. Try and see if there's any activity in this grass first. I mean, it's shallow right there. That is real shallow. I think what I found in practice is I get too hung up in one spot when I only have, you know, half a day and one full day tomorrow. But you know, tomorrow you don't want to catch those fish. You want to get bit, but you don't want to like set into them. Try to shake them off the best you can, because those fish you end up accidentally catching on Friday that you do hook, more than likely they're not gonna eat again on Saturday for that same thing. Now I won't say it won't happen, but you just cut your odds in half by a lot. All right, sorry if the wind noise is like really bad on the audio, but the wind is blowing. Anyways, we found this really cool creek way in the back. It was under a road, it's not even showing on the map. I see a bunch of fish swimming around. It's just too windy to the point to where I can't tell if those are giant bass, like biggins, or carp. Because I saw some bass on bed, and I also saw some carp. So I can't tell if there's more bass in here, more carp. I can't tell a difference. Just enough chop on the water to like kind of make them look similar. So what I'm gonna do is tomorrow, it's supposed to be less windy. I'm gonna come up here in the morning. I'm not even gonna fish this in the morning. I'm just gonna come look and be really quiet, and I'm turn on my graphs and just see if those are bass. We're coming back, because we could get like a 25 pound bag out of here. Like, they're biggins. And I saw a good one on bed, so that's why I wasn't sure on what was going on, if it was bass or carp, like I'm saying. Oops. So there goes that. All right, well, I didn't see that log. Turn the motor off. Thankfully, it wasn't going very fast. Anyways, like I'm saying, we're gonna come back here tomorrow. It's a run, so it's a risk to come all the way up here, but what I think I'm gonna do is just, first thing in the morning, I'm gonna trailer in up here, pull the boat out, and go back down to where we're supposed to launch, and check some more around there. I didn't realize how far of a run that was all the way up here. We're up here now, it's what it is. We'll come back tomorrow if we can get some more bites up here. We're gonna keep going left, up deeper into these, the main creek arms. Turns into like a big shallow flat. So that's gonna tell me if they're hanging off those fingers of the lake, or they're just in those subtle pockets off the main lake. So those are my two options that I'm gonna look for. I'm not even gonna bother deep. The water's 68 degrees. I don't think they're gonna be quite deep yet. I'm sure some are gonna start moving their way out, but majority of the population is gonna be on the bank, if not close to still. So, fingers crossed, or hopefully we'll run into something. Alrighty guys, we're gonna call it for today. The wind's supposed to get really nasty. It's supposed to start raining here pretty quick. It's 6:40. Gonna go get some food in me. Yeah, we didn't catch a lot of fish today, but I learned a lot. I learned that I'm not coming to this part of the lake. There's nothing but carp, and I'm not seeing any active bass around, nor am I seeing any on beds. So tomorrow, we're gonna go on the other end of the lake. There's a couple areas that I really wanna check out on that end. And that is probably most likely where we're gonna start our tournament and finish the tournament. We're just gonna be down there in general. That being said, tomorrow, I'm gonna cut the hook off of a lot of baits, see if we can get something to bite, and then we'll shake them off. Thank you all for watching day one of the practice video. We'll see you guys tomorrow. We're gonna get some food in us and get off this lake before the weather gets real nasty. See y'all.